In this video, we're just going to look at the Z position. The Z position is basically all your reports, generally speaking, that you'll be running at either at the end of the shift or day or perhaps period on some of the periodic reports. So all we need to do is obviously have the manager key in the machine and turn it round to Z. And you'll see that there's a host of different reports in here. We use a down arrow, it'll flip through some of the different reports that are available, including, which is really potentially quite useful, the electronic journal. So as you're doing any transactions, it's storing the data electronically in the working memory, and you can use this option to either print off an audit, so your whole journal, or you can drill down a bit closer. So if you wanted to look for a particular receipt or transaction, you can use the search facilities in here. And then you've also got the periodics. So although you're perhaps running a daily financial report, you may want to run a periodic report, which quite a lot of customers might do, say perhaps once a week or month or quarter, depending on how it ties in with your accounts and your books. So like all machines, when you run a Z report, it's only resetting that individual one. So for example, the most common Z report that you'll be using is the Z financial. So when I run that individual report, that's the only one that's resetting. So anything below, like the departments, the clerks and so on, they don't reset. To run the report, it's obviously highlight the correct report that you want, and then you just press the subtotal button, which is also enter. And so pretty standard and similar to a lot of the reports from any cash register. So here's our Z financial report. It will give you summaries at the top of what's actually happened in terms of gross sales, any percentages or fixed value discounts that you've done. Also gives you a summary of any cancelled transactions. And then probably most importantly is kind of your figures at the bottom, so your cash in cards and also your cash in draw, which takes account any paid in or paid outs. So they're kind of the numbers that you're particularly interested in when you come to cash up. And obviously that this cash figure here, the cash in draw, is obviously what should match what you've physically got in the drawer. On this machine, what it does is you have that financial report as a standalone. You then have a department report. So these department keys would generally be programmed up for your different areas, your different products, or groups of products, I should say. So again, highlighting here, and you just press the subtotal. And so this one then gives you your sales since the last time this individual report's been run, and it will give you your quantities and your values just below the department name. Obviously all of these department names obviously are editable and programmable in the program mode. So that department one might, you know, become hot food, for example. So you've got values, quantities, and also percentage. So if I ran that report again, it's obviously going to be empty because we've just reset it. There is a few different reports in here. So you've got clerks and PLU. So if you do use those functions, you can run those reports as well. Tables, so it just gives you a breakdown and a printout of tables. So there is a table function down here. You've got an individual report just for refunds as well. So, you know, that might be quite good to have as an order. So you can just print off all your refunds. So in here, we'll keep it simple, we'll just print all rather than using the period or the number. And actually, we don't have any refunds to print off. Your electronic journal, like I say, opening this one, there are some search facilities, so you can do it by period. So within there, you can do a from and a to in terms of date. If you know a receipt number or group of numbers, again, you can do a from and to, but if you knew it was receipt number 37, it will show you on screen, and then you can press the print info. And you'll see on the top of all the receipts, it does have its bill number printed just below the date and time. So if I just quickly turn around to registration, if I do a quick sale. You'll see here, so there's a receipt number, so that one's 39. So like I say, that electronic journal is quite powerful to check something or produce a copy of it if required. You can do all. The only thing with that is it's going to print off your whole journal, so it's fine if you do physically want a whole audit trail of it. But obviously, if you're looking more for something that perhaps happened today or yesterday, using the period is going to be a lot safer and consume a lot less paper. Even though we are in Zed, when you run the journal, it's not resetting the journal. If you did require resetting your journal, if you just go back to this screen, you just press the cancel followed by the subtotal button, and you'll get a message on here. Are you sure you want to cancel it? Clear it, sorry. And if you do, you press the subtotal. I will just press back now. Your periodic. So it looks very similar to the financial report, but this one, like I say, this is over a longer period potentially. So that report is since the last time this individual periodic report's been ran. So like I say, you might be doing a Z daily, but your periodic possibly weekly, monthly, quarterly. You do have an hourly report, and the system does hold stock, or potentially hold stock against PLU, so you can run that report as well if need be. There is an option in X and Z to run all the reports, so it's going to literally print out everything. Probably unlikely that you'll ever use that, but perhaps if it was you closing down the business perhaps or repurposing the cash register, you might do the all reports just to print everything out and get them back down to zero.